37 comes straight after this. I decided to make this video after a friend of mine visited this lovely country of Georgia. In front of me there's bus 37, that's the bus that takes you to the airport. It's a very important bus. It runs every 30 minutes for 24 hours. They do have the train from the airport to the city, but hardly runs. So the best way to get from the airport to the city is to actually use bus 37, the blue bus 37. It costs very, very little. It's less than $50 cents, like 50 tetri. It's very, very little. But if you try to use taxis, oh my God, they're going to charge you a fortune. My friends were charged 3 times the normal price, 60 lari just to town, which normally cost 50 tetris. Imagine that. I decided to make this video so I can help others. I'm at the airport right now. Lovely, lovely, beautiful airport. I can see 2 commercial airlines. I'm not going to mention their name because they're not sponsoring me for this video. The reason why I'm at the airport, it's because of airport touts. There are plenty of airport touts when you're traveling. You might have come across them if you do travel, but it's not only airport touts. There are bus touts at bus stations, train stations, but airport touts, they're like serious hustlers. They know what they're doing, and you cannot tell from a good one to a bad one. Some of them are aggressive. So how do you know which touts is more genuine? You don't, because they are not interested in you as a person. They're only interested in you parting with your money. As soon as you part with your money, they move on to the next victim. My friend visited a country, Georgia, beautiful country, and he was overcharged. They charged him 3 times the normal price of transport to town. Normally it's like 20, 25 lari, but they charge him 60. So I thought maybe I should make a video just so that some of you will know about this. But it's not only this country I'm talking about, there are other countries as well. My friend lost, another friend was traveling in India. He went there and overcharged him, because these people come and then offer you, take you somewhere by taxi. They say, oh, we are the cheapest. My best advice is, don't listen to everything that everybody say, all right? The best thing is, when you arrive in any country, find somewhere to sit. Sit down, maybe at a coffee shop, or and grab a glass of water or cup of tea or cup of coffee, and just relax. Collect your thoughts. Just process everything. And after half an hour, you'll have a clear mind. Because when you're traveling, you don't have a clear mind. You're more bothered about, oh, I need to get there very, very quickly. I need to do this, I need to do that. But if you can sit down just for a bit and just relax, and if you're not sure whether there is a public transport from the airport where you are, then you can basically ask the people working at the airport, inside the airport, if there are police officers, ask those. But I always ask twice or thrice to different people. You got somebody working at the shop and ask that person, then you go to a different shop or different restaurant, ask another, and then ask the policeman. Then that way you have the best prices of their local transport, because touts, they come in all different forms. Some of them will offer to carry your baggage around. It's your luggage, you've been carrying it all over the place. Why will you need somebody to carry it for you? Traveling is not for lazy people. When you know the right price, then you can start haggling. You can say, no, the right price is this. I'm not gonna pay twice the normal price when I know the price, or 3 times the normal price.
Bus 37 straight from the airport, that's what you should use when you come to Georgia. It's not expensive, it's very cheap. I'm getting in it right now. Here I am inside bus 37, which is the transport from Tbilisi airport to Tbilisi center. You can do the same with Kutaisi airport. There are buses there that will take you to Kutaisi center. So this is an example of what you can do in every country that you go. You can always ask for the airport buses, the airport trains or airport metros before you jump in taxis, because airport taxis, they are known to rip people off. They are known to be extremely expensive. So just bear that in mind, because if you don't, then you're bound to part with a lot of money. This is the bus which I'm taking. I'm right in front of the airport, Tbilisi airport. The nicest thing in Georgia is people are very, very nice and very friendly. And other countries will be like that as well. There are countries where airport touting is against the law. Many countries have got plenty of these airport touts. Some of them will rob you, some of them will make you pay too much, some of them. Oh, here's another perfect example. Because I've got friends around the world, another friend of mine was visiting and he'd booked a hostel, but he didn't tell me. He told me once he arrived. So when he got to the airport, the airport touts, who happened to be taxi drivers at the same time, told him, "Ma, we know the place, we can take you there. But it will be like $50 instead of 30 lari, $50. So he didn't know, he took the taxi and they didn't take him to the hostel that is booked. They said, "Well, we can't find that one, but we can take you to a different one." Different one meaning to some hostel where they can get a commission. So there's always that. So always try by all means to avoid this kind of touting, this aggressive touting, because you don't know who's nice, you don't know who's good. Genuinely, honestly, how are you going to know? In Georgia, Tbilisi, they do not use Uber. A lot of these Soviet countries, they don't use Uber. They use what's called Yandex. As soon as you arrive, before you leave the airport, you see them? Another touts. I'm gonna be hassled now. You find a lot of them, they do this. They come in and ask you for money. They're like gypsies. And they've got a tendency of sending young children to hassle the men, the male travelers or male foreigners, the kids. These are very little kids. They're like 4, 5, 6, 7 years old. And these kids will come and grab your legs and ask for money. And when they grab your leg, they start putting their hands in your pocket and start trying to pickpocket you. So you need to watch out for that. And once you give them money, they'll never leave you alone. The touts are bound to charge you quite a lot. But if you use Yandex taxi, then it will be much cheaper. And when you're in the city, Tbilisi city as well, you can use Yandex. You'll be surprised at how much the taxi is. A friend of mine was charged almost $4 to $5 on a journey. That's normally 50 cents. But then I told him, you know, you should listen to me, take Yandex. Then he started taking Yandex and everything was fine. So many minibuses. These are called mashutkas in former Soviet Union countries. In Tbilisi, we have yellow ones, just like New York have the yellow cabs. Here they have these yellow minibuses, which they call mashutkas, for the city Tbilisi. The thing with minibuses here, they get overloaded, and sometimes there's no room to move because it's so parked. Hopefully when I get on the next one, you guys might be able to see what I'm talking about. So in Georgia, the kind of minibuses which they use is the Ford Transit and also
Mercedes Sprinter. In Armenia, they use Russian-made vehicles, and also Azerbaijan and Russia itself. And those are very bumpy, not comfy at all. Sorry, Russia, you need to start designing better minibuses. The last time I got on one of those ones made in Russia, I end up with a bad back. Oh, my. So here I'm at the famous Vaxal. So when you come to Georgia, if you're looking for the station, you say Vaxal. It's like almost all Soviet countries. If you say Vaxal, it basically means train station or bus station. We got an idiot who just beeped the horn. The one over there is the metro station. And I'm going to be going to the train station, which is over there. Long distance mashutkas or minibuses. Those are the ones that goes for very long distances, and they are comfier. Some of them have got TV screens inside, but the local ones, like that yellow one, they get overloaded with people and pack and backpacks. And if it's on a busy day, a busy morning, and you got a backpack, they don't stop for you, these town ones. They just leave you, they just drive off. The only problem with the mashutka is in the summer when it's very hot, and they overpark them, overload them, and there's so many bodies in there, it becomes difficult to breathe because you really cannot open many windows. The windows at the back can open, only the back and front, and that's it. And that's where the big problem is with the mashutka. So I think this is my mashutka. No. Local mashutkas have numbers. Long distance mashutkas don't. The numbers which they have, these local mashutkas, indicate the part of town where you're going. Whereas a long distance one, you take one from Tbilisi to Batumi, or Tbilisi to Sagarejo or Tel Aviv, the wine region, or you take one to Kazbegi, the mountain region. When you're not sure of the price of mashutkas, whether it's local or long distance ones, ask local people. The best people to ask, shop workers or those working at the market. We have loads of fruits and veg markets around Tbilisi, loads of them. So you can ask those people, and they're very nice. They will tell you. Don't go and ask a taxi driver or ask a mashutka driver, because they're gonna overcharge you, because that just means you don't know what you're asking for. You know, believe it or not, I mean, what is called a mashutka, this minibus is like, it's a four transit. I think maybe it's a converted like from a minivan, and they call it mashutka here. And as you can see, it's overloaded, and some people are just standing. It's quite nice, it's very interesting, something different, something that you're not used to, but that's what life is, isn't it? You gotta learn. And this to me, it's good, it's amazing. Say hello.
Mr.
Sandy. No, I have to go. Yes, I have to. Yeah, we can take photo next time. No problem. Say hello.
Hello.
I'm sitting here with Georgian people. Very, very welcoming. I was just passing.
Oh, Sandy, that's what you put. Sandy, Sandy. Photo, yes, they're right. He's here, he's in Georgia.
Yeah. Oh, wow, I'm sitting with Georgian people here. I was going back to my hostel, and they just stopped me and say, hey, let's say hello.
All right.
So guys, let's say hello.
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 Hello. Gavarjova. Requia.
Mancho.
Mancho. Okay, fun. Nice name. And you? Jabba. Jabba Dabba. And
so
tomorrow.
So
that. Ata angliski so maybe. So means maybe, yes.
Maybe
and yeah, Shane?
Maho.
So that's Maho. Yeah. I've been welcomed by these guys, man. That's why I love Georgia so much. Georgia is a hiker's paradise. I just been walking and the guys just stopped me there and they wanted me to sit down with them, take a photo, drink some chacha, which is Georgian vodka, stronger than vodka. The one that they make at their homes is like 70% of alcohol. That's serious spirit. Very, very serious. The spirit is just too, the alcohol is just too high. The nicest thing hiking in Georgia, because the people are so nice, you don't need permission to put a tent anywhere you want. One time I was hiking in Zalha, and people told me there were wolves there. I shouldn't camp in the mountains, in the forest. So I decided to ask the police, and they said, no, you can't. And I said, well, it's late now. I don't think I can find a hostel. Can I camp in your garden, please? And the police said, yeah, no problem. So I camped at Zalha Garden with the police. Amazing, amazing. Imagine, where else can you do that? Huh? That's why I love this country. I love the people. Very nice, very welcoming, very friendly, and they love a drink. Yeah.